Hey manufacturers, you're gonna like this one. MISys is on the road to go visit Scanivalve in Spokane, Washington. Charlie Kimball and I are flying out of Boston with a stop in Dallas, then on to Spokane, where we will meet with the very talented Arda Akolo. Arda works for Central Nervous Systems out of Vancouver, which is a top-tier MISys implementation partner working with Scanivalve to implement MISys Manufacturing into their 70-year-old company. We are here to meet with Ryan Pemberton, Vice President, Owner, Operations Manager, take your pick. He wears a lot of hats, but he sure knows his stuff.
The name of the company is Scanivalve. It was founded by my grandfather. 1956.
Today, Scanivalve makes precision pressure and temperature instrumentation. Ryan tells us what started off with the development of a pressure instrument specific to the aviation industry has expanded into products and applications for numerous industries like aerospace, wind tunnels, jet engines, wind turbines, automotive, even F1 and NASCAR racing. But also their products are used in the development and design of buildings and bridges, and even in the study of sand dunes. Absolutely fascinating. Scanivalve is located in Liberty Lake, Washington, just east of Spokane, and have been a MISys customer since 2023. They use MISys with QuickBooks Enterprise. MISys modules include basic manufacturing, advanced purchasing, advanced production, MRP, shop floor control, bin tracking, MISys EXT, and mobile alerts.
I've been here for 17 years. I've worked through customer support. I've done traveling sales. I've done the engineering just as an engineer. I think one of my job titles is still engineering manager. And then through the transition to the prior MRP service, it was a complete disaster. Yeah. I kind of took over production. I wouldn't say I led that.
Okay.
I took over production. So as the last 5 years, it's been kind of this slow land grab of what's my responsibility towards it all being my responsibility.
Yeah. Wow. Okay.
Ryan tells us they went through two previous software systems. One, a complex and expensive ERP. And two, a more affordable and simpler system that claimed to have MRP. But as Scanivalve discovered,
it was not connected to our accounting system. It never was connected to our accounting system. We had two different islands.
Right.
That was a flow of forests worth of paper back and forth.
Yes.
And manual reentry.
Yeah.
That was a nightmare. And that was when I said, like, okay, we got to do something different. We weren't even a year into the prior when it's like, this is not working for us. And as awful and arduous as the process is to transition MRP systems, we got to do it again, and we got to do it right now.
Yeah.
And we got to do it right.
So before choosing their next system, Ryan decided to hire an expert consultant.
He said, I will talk to you, understand your application, understand your requirements, and come up with three different recommendations of who you should look into. And at the top of that list was MISys.
Right.
So then we reached out to MISys, you guys, right? And said, hey, we don't want to do this alone. That was a disaster. We've done it alone. Who do we go to? I'm willing to throw all the money at this. So we bought your guys' help plan. We paid for the startup cost.
We did everything. Yeah.
And we went with the top of your list of who's the best support that we can get. And that was CNS, right?
Yeah.
So we said, okay, I'm not going through the nightmare again. We want to build a foundation that we can actually build on and expand on, and it's going to be working for us. You know, you guys helped produce us some nice travelers. We never had this before. Every traveler we ever had for any of our prior processes had one step. It just said, go to the machine shop department or go to assembly department, and that was it.
And whoever had it would know where it needed to go afterwards, right?
So we have, separate from that, we have, this is a machine programming guide.
Yep.
And we have manually produced word travelers
that,
especially for the machine shop, because our prior machine shop foreman was a very organized guy. And he was, before we were even ISO certified, he was on the quality train. And he did a really good job to help build in this culture of keeping it clean, and build processes and write travelers and all that stuff for us. So now I've been able to go through in the background and take these Word documents and put that straight into the router information in MISys, and now it's in one central location and it's managed correctly, and everybody has visibility to it, not just the machine shop. So what's pretty cool, you know, from the MISys perspective or from the MRP perspective, this guy, this part here has like 6 BOM levels to it. By the time we machine the base, what we call the header, and then we send it out to anodize. That used to be 2 separate levels. We've been able to merge that into one level now that we have detailed routers that tell us what to do with it. Then we glue it up. So we put all the tubes in. And as we've gone to the mill turn that you'll see, this used to go through 3 different machining steps, and now it's just a single machine part, right? And then it goes into an assembly. So it gets the collar on the outside and an identifier plate that identifies each of these tubes and goes together in an assembly set. So this dumb thing, it's in a lot of ways the simplest part we would make, has more router steps or more BOM levels than our final top level products, our pressure scanners, right? And that's where we can program in epoxy dry times. We can program in her setup time to get her epoxy out and mix it up. And how long is it going to take to gather all the right tubes together? And then the cure times, and it works. This assemble step is probably a 2-minute step. So even 100 of them, you know, that's not even going to take me an hour to do it. This whole process, human time is like less than a day. But with the cure times and everything in there, I have scheduled a 8-hour delay in every single step, and that lets parts come up to a shelf, and then she can sit and schedule it. Because otherwise it's gonna say, hey, I don't need these lower level parts until the morning, and then they can be done at the end of the day. So there's some maybe gratuitous delays in our schedule, but it works out really well for us. I think part of that is just being a 70-year-old company. You know, we have this kind of rhythm that works, and I'm trying to put structure around that with a process and a system that lets us do that. And so that lets me, you know, one of the great things that's awesome about MISys, I can build this Kanban system in my router steps for Cindy and for her little department. And I can handle a different department, a different process completely differently, right? Everything from here over is assembled. Everything in those shelves out there is outside purchase stuff. So this is a MISys raw material, right? Outside purchase thing. We buy it, it comes in. Hopefully we do nothing to it. We just bolt it on something. But even we can rework outside purchase stuff, right? So these are all parts that we've manufactured at some point.
That always gets tricky too, right? Is it in raw material or finished goods? Is it live in QuickBooks, live in MISys, right?
So some of this stuff is build to order. So it's going to sit here. It's going to be basically empty until we get an order come along. And it's going to be a build to order item. So we have a mix of build to stock, build to order, outside purchase, raw materials. I mean, it's, and that was for us, we never had a differentiation in our heads between build to stock or build to order. We would have these hours of arduous conversation saying, but in this case, we don't want to build ahead because why would we have all this inventory sitting on if we're not going to get an order coming in? You know, and hey, we can build it in 4 weeks and we're running on a 10-week lead time. That's fine. And then by the end of the conversation, we'd have our heads totally flipped over and we'd be talking about a totally different product saying like, we know we're going to sell it. We know people want short lead times. Why are we not just building, you know, and this, and so by the nature of the way MISys works on min stock and reorder levels and all that, we've been able to sort of wrap our heads around, hey, we can treat these parts different. We can have effectively 2 processes in the building based on reorder levels. We can totally set that. We can set a reorder level to 0 or 1. And as soon as it's demanded, MRP is going to run and it's going to pop us up and tell us to go build one of them, or maybe we want to build 5 of them because it's an efficient number to build.
So before MISys, we're using a universal approach. Either going to make the stock or we're going to make to order, either A or B. And then now you can do A and B.
Yes, except it was even worse than that because you say system, and system was somebody's noggin. You know, one day, last time so-and-so told me to build 20 of these. And so I'm going to go build 20 of them, even though we have an order for one of them, and it's the only order for that one we're going to get in 5 years. But so-and-so said build 20 of these, and this terrible, terrible system.
Yeah. So you have better control. Do you have lower inventory?
Well, our inventory is actually up like 50% in the last year, but that's by design.
Sales?
Yeah. So we were effectively operating on, I'm not going to say just in time, almost in time, you know, mentality, right? We had this this idea of just in time. Hey, we can just quote 15 weeks, and as soon as we get that order, we can just order, boom, boom, everything we need, and that lets us build in 15 weeks.
That's when all the suppliers actually supply you with the goods.
Yes, exactly. That never worked out well for us, and consistently, and it was so horrible because we were jerking our suppliers around. You know, we'd go to them 1 week and say, hey, I need three of these, and the next week I need four of them, and the next week I need two of them, instead of give me 20 of them, right? So we were jerking our suppliers around. They weren't meeting their deadlines and their due dates. It was screwing us. So now we're trying to build stuff last minute and still shipping it out late. So by design, our inventory levels are up, but they're up on the right parts.
Gotcha.
Which is neat. Right. So I'm going to say the last 12 months, our lead times on average have come down from 20 weeks to 10 weeks. And our on time has gone from as bad as 60% on time to 85, 90, 95% on time.
Wow, fantastic.
Those are incredible stats.
That is incredible.
Yeah. Yeah.
One of the other big changes that we've made with MISys, it was driven by the change to MISys, is, excuse the terminology, I don't know where it came from, I don't know if it means anything, we used to bake kits. So we would come along and say, hey, this is an 18-week out part, lead time, better start the kit, you're gonna walk around this room and grab everything we can grab today. And now it's on a shelf, a kit, with 10% of its parts in it. And then we'd order stuff, and some stuff would be on a 2-week lead time. So 2 weeks later, it'd come up, and we'd say, oh, cool, we got our part, and we're going to go put it in the kit. And then 3 weeks later, more stuff would show up. Oh, cool, we got our parts, we'd put it in the kit. And those kits live down on the production floor. So now our production team is going, hey, I can start on that job. I can't get it done, but I can start on that job. So I'd have production personnel working on 10 different jobs in a day. I can start on this, and I can put this together, and I can start on that, and I can put that together. Inevitably, what that leads to when you compare it with the just out of time method that I was just telling you is, okay, we're late on part A here, but I just put part A on this module over here. So I'm going to go over here, I'm going to disassemble this module, I'm going to take part A off of it, and I'm going to move it over here and put part A on this job, and I'm going to ship that out the door. And it was so chaotic and so disorganized and so difficult to manage where anything was, and it was entirely dependent on the individual supervisor or the department lead in their head knowing, oh, I have a job going for this over here that I can steal parts from and I can move them over there. Ultimately, when it comes to shipping it out the door, we have no idea what the costing is on that. We have no idea if I'm stealing parts from here and moving them over there, what's that really doing? It was a firefight. It was constant firefight.
Sure.
Set up each time for the same part over and over
again. So now, MISys is, we're able to program in the lead times with routers. We know when I need a part to get it an assembly done here. We are able to buy ahead. We're letting ourselves do that, right? We're having better conversations with our suppliers to get parts more on time in higher volumes. So that when a date comes up and when a kit is ready to kit, all the parts are available. Kathy runs a report and it says, hey, these MOs are ready to go kit. And she walks around and she kits them and she takes them out to the department supervisor and says, go build this. And it gets built.
All in one fell swoop.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. Huh. I was going through routers for one of our very important, the temperature product, right?
Yeah.
I was trying to build out a router for this temperature product. And I was talking to the main guy that builds them. And I said, okay, you know, how long is it going to take you to do this? And how long is it going to take you to do that? And he said, well, if this, and it was this really kind of convoluted conversation. I said, yeah, but you got to imagine you just have all the parts, right? If you're just start to finish, you have all the parts. And he looked at me and he said, I've never had that. I've never had a complete kit. Oh, and he's been here for 5 years and he's our lead on this product. I've never had a complete kit.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. That's amazing.
Right, so before MISys, every part, every kit, every job was a handwritten label. I think we have an inventory control problem here.
Yeah,
Yeah. Right. So now we get a label.
Much better. Yeah.
And it's a barcode label.
Yeah.
So I can scan that. They can tell me about it.
Yeah.
Before Scanivalve, I worked for John Deere. So I came from a monster company where I was one of, I was employee number 43,000. And so moving to a small business, I love the heartbeat that everybody feels and the significance of what you're doing impacts the guy sitting next to me or the girl in the back there, right? You know, we all depend on each other. But I don't really know, in my mind, the really high mix, low volume customization blend of outside purchase and custom manufactured parts for us and stuff that we custom manufacture. I mean, it's we have a foot in just about every camp in the whole production process.
Yeah.
And
I would say
we're able to reach our hands around that with MISys and handle all of those in a unique way that need to be handled.
Yeah, that's fantastic. I would say without the benefit of any kind of data, that your story is very typical of the customers we deal with, especially with a generational transfer, mm-hmm. where the generation before you had everything in their head,
yep.
and then just trying to evolve from that to a data-driven, process-oriented system
as
the greatest challenge.
It is, yeah. We want to be that average user. We want to be in the middle mainstream of what you do. We don't want to be on the edge. We don't want to be a fringe.
Yeah.
We want to fit what you guys design the product for, and we'll rebuild our processes and tweak as we need to fit within the main line.
Yeah.
Like, we had so many problems of custom reports breaking and, oh, we need to do X, Y, and Z, so we got to work around the system here. That caused so many enduring heartaches on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah.
And being able to be the average user using the system the way that it's supposed to be used. Is amazing.
And a sweet spot. It's great to hear.
Great time at Scanivalve. We're gonna head out and get some lunch. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
To learn more about MISys Manufacturing MRP software, visit us online at MISysInc.com.